Yeah, Boston United 224. 4,000, we got some stuff back. We'd like to go take a look at the ILS, the 22 left, if we can.
At a 224, no problem. Are you ready for that at this time?
Yes, sir.
At a 224, you're clear to the Boston Airport.
Welcome, YouTube viewers and subscribers, to another episode of Route 66. I'll start off by apologizing straight up. Upon starting to edit the video, I noticed that the audio was not recorded at all during the game time. I think it's because I switched from headphones to my speakers, and for some reason Prepar3D didn't pick up, or the or Shadowplay didn't pick up. So you're getting a bit of background music as well as my narration today, but no plane audio, which I'm very, very sorry about. A bit of a rookie mistake, but yeah, we'll do a bit of a quick video today as a result of that, and I will try and give you some of the best commentary I can, because I've already done this flight. I'm not doing it live, so yeah, and as you can see, we're taking off. Flying in Veo again, which was in our previous flight. And also, as mentioned in the previous video, we're flying from Amarillo in Texas across to Albuquerque in New Mexico. It feels weird not hearing any volume at all, just the sound of my own voice. Anyway, I hope everyone's well, as I always say. It was fantastic to see the amount of very positive feedback from my first video, well, my first two videos with Prepar3D, the first one being the teaser that I did, and also moved across to Route 66, or moved across to Prepar3D for Route 66 rather. So just having a bit of a look at the view of Amarillo. It's pretty bloody good for stock standard scenery. There's no add-on packs apart from the Orbix open land class. So yeah, pretty impressive. So we're sort of just getting into our flight plan today, sorry. And yeah, it looks like we should get a reasonably straight run through the weather. I'm using live weather with Active Sky 16, as I'll be doing for the remainder of this series. And a few clouds about. As we get further into New Mexico, it starts to get a bit cloudier, but it looks like it's going to be a reasonably fine sort of a flight. I'm cruising at around 8,000 feet, although I noticed that Albuquerque, unless I'm mistaken, is at high altitude, so we might have to make an adjustment to that later in the flight. So we'll do a bit of a time lapse, as you'll see, which will take us right through to our approach into Albuquerque. I'll sort of phase out, or make a shorter time lapse rather, because of the disappointment with the audio. But yeah, looking forward to showing you Albuquerque, and yeah, we're getting pretty close to the west coast now. But lesson learned with the audio. Upon reflection, I'm fairly certain it was probably Shadowplay getting a little bit upset. I've got a headset that I use for a majority of the time. However, I thought I'd just move to the speakers as I'm sort of home alone at the moment. I'm not babysitting my daughter at the moment, so I thought, oh, well, I'll crank it out on the actual speakers. And I did that during during loading of Prepar3D. So Yeah, a bit disappointed, but saves me having to do another flight. It is a rather long flight, so, and we've got a tight schedule. Just trying to get this GPS working. I'm still getting my head around GPS's, the whole interface and whatnot, so sort of have a play around when I can. I know I bang on it about a fair much, but I absolutely am in love with P3D. It's just it's reinvigorated my love for flight simming. Not that I lost it. It's just nice to have a stable sort of a platform. Anyway, probably going to move into some time lapse now. So I hope you enjoy the music and the flight, and I'll see you on approach to Albuquerque. Alright, and we're back. So, makes it a bit hard for me I'm not actually flying the plane at the moment, so, by the looks of it, I think we are about 10 minutes away from Albuquerque, so we're going to be starting to do a descent shortly. I don't want to descend too much because I've noticed there is a rather dramatic change in altitude. So once we get to our next waypoint, we'll be doing a a right-hand turn. Well, I think we'll come over a couple of mountains and then we shall see Albuquerque. I'm just having a look at the scenery. I'm just love how it's sort of changed as I've crossed America. We've sort of gone into that green part where we can see a lot of the fall sort of looking colours, the oranges and the browns. Now we've got this sort of, I wouldn't say alpine, but you can see that there's a, well, the terrain itself's changed to sort of like a more sandy colour. And the trees are sort of that more, I don't know, it does remind me of some place about 30 km out of Adelaide, where it looks like a massive sort of a sand area with the sort of big pine trees. I am certainly enjoying the Navajo. I think we'll sort of use this one for the remainder of the Route 66 series. Then I'll do some further testing with some different aircraft. There's a couple that I've seen that Oz Flight Sim uses that I certainly want to grab, and also seen a few others that are on the on Frugal's reviews that he does, or updates, news. It's been a busy week for this channel. As I might have mentioned, I had a lot of strife updating the LSPD FR module within GTA. I had to do a complete clean install, which is no easy feat. The download for GTA alone, I think, is 60 gig. Thank God for NBN, I guess. and just rebuilt that from scratch, so that's taken up a lot of my time. But really keen to sort of get some more videos out there, so you guys will be seeing this with a bit of luck. I don't really want to break the schedule, but you might see this tonight, being a Wednesday night. If not, I'll be on a Thursday night time slot. I sort of haven't stuck with my schedule, which I mentioned in my vlog back in September. Wow, I just realised I missed an October vlog. Where did that month go? But yeah, there's going to be some changes to the channel as far as scheduling. I want to sort of ramp up more videos as I've got more subscribers now. And I certainly want to keep you guys around. But also sort of get more people on board. So as it's getting closer to the holiday period, although this month is, I'm going to be extremely busy with commitments, I'm still going to be able to do the almost guarantee that there'll be a Sunday night and a Tuesday night episode of GTA and Prepar3D. But I'm hoping to sort of do a few others during the week, especially if I'm sort of really playing GTA, then there's nothing stopping me from having, say, 3 videos out a week of that. And the same with Prepar3D. I'm just really admiring the scenery here. It's yeah, really nice. So yeah, lots more content coming in the coming weeks. I'll have a bit of a break over Christmas, so hoping to get a few more out as well. I just cannot get over how wonderful the graphics are with Prepar3D for scenery. That really does sort of look so real, like you're approaching a sort of a major town or city over in the distance. It's so cool. I'm just I'm blown away by it. It's nice to be able to sort of showcase what my video card can do. Prepar3D, at times it was impressive. Most of you remember the Uluru video I did. That was probably the high point of this channel with Flight Simulator, or just the channel in general. It certainly got the biggest amount of views, but Yeah, it's just saying the difference in P3D and flight simming. Flight Simulator X when it comes to graphical quality. It's got the flaps down now, landing gear, so not too far away now. No traffic, which is a pleasant sign after my last video. I've since found out that was most likely the reason I was experiencing so much sort of turbulence was a jet wash from that Learjet that was in front of me. Doesn't look like we'll be having that danger today. For traffic, that is, but there is a bit of turbulence around. So from here, and with aircraft audio, our next episode is from Albuquerque, and we're going to fly into Sedona, which I'm really excited about, because I will have, within the next 24 hours, I'm going to purchase the Sedona Scenery add-on from Orbix. And it's one of the ones I've wanted from day one. I've always had a liking for Sedona, and it's a place I certainly want to visit one day. My late nana, she went to America when I was about 2 years old, and she had a photo album, well, three photo albums full of photos, and she actually ended up giving them to me because of my, I wouldn't say obsession, but my dream of going to America. But one of the places that she went to and took some stunning photos was Sedona. There is a bit of turbulence, as you can see. Very nice lineup. And almost there. And touchdown. Welcome to Albuquerque, New Mexico. Well, thank you for those that have stuck around just to hear my voice today. Yeah, it's amazing. An aeroplane noise can be so annoying, but at the same time, it sort of has that nice ambience when you've got it. It won't happen again. So yeah, next episode, hopefully later this week, otherwise Sunday night. That'll be Albuquerque to Sedona. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Appreciate your support as always, and have a pleasant evening. Goodbye.